three decades, he was Egypt's strongman. But it took just 18 days of protests to topple Hosni Mubarak.
President Hosni Mubarak has decided to step down as head of state and to entrust the affairs of state to the Supreme Council of the Armed Forces.
Hosni Mubarak was Egypt's longest-serving president. In his time in power, he came to be regarded as a key regional ally by the West, despite his authoritarian rule. Born in 1928, Hosni Mubarak was first and foremost a military man. Having served as Minister of Defense, he was promoted to Air Marshal for his distinguished record during the Yom Kippur War. The war hero became president after the assassination of Anwar Sadat in 1981, a leader who had signed a controversial peace treaty with his Israeli counterpart. For much of Mubarak's first decade in power, Egypt remained suspended from the Arab League. His continued engagement with Israel angered many at home and abroad. But the strategy won praise from the United States and also put Mubarak in prime position to assume the role of key negotiator in the neighboring conflict.
This new phase needs to be the phase of peace, to bring about total peace and create an independent Palestinian state.
While in office, Mubarak actively clamped down on Islamist movements and imposed a state of emergency. His stance earned him vital support from the US. Washington sent over $1 billion a year to Cairo in military aid. While receiving Western support, Mubarak continued to be accused of human rights abuses, muzzling the press and stifling the opposition. Over the years, he was re-elected four times. On three occasions, he ran unopposed. Along with his autocratic rule, it was persistent poverty and anger at entrenched corruption that brought hundreds of thousands of demonstrators onto the streets in early 2011. At first, the president remained defiant.
This great nation is my homeland. I have lived in it, I fought for it and defended its soil, sovereignty and interests. On its soil I will die. History will judge me and all of us.
His judicial reckoning came sooner rather than later. Shortly after his resignation, Egypt held its first democratic election. Mohamed Morsi became president and Mubarak was tried, accused of complicity in killing hundreds of protesters. On June 2, 2012, he was found guilty and sentenced to life in prison. But a year later, military rule returned when another top military figure, General Abdel Fattah el-Sisi, overthrew Morsi. In 2017, Hosni Mubarak was acquitted on appeal. He walked free after 6 years behind bars. Mubarak's last years were split between his seaside villa in Sharm el-Sheikh and a military hospital in Cairo.
Well, that's it for us for Middle East Matters this week. Thank you for watching.